What's up, squad? We back at it again, man. When he thought it was finna end, you already know. Thank y'all for riding with me. Where you locked in with Stories with V, man. Make sure you like, share, comment, smash that subscribe button, man, and shoot your boy a cash app for the return and everybody that's always on the team. Salute to the people that's on the team, staying on the team, and never planning on leaving the team, man. I do it for y'all. What's up, the squad today, man? We just a quick tab in. Had a couple good stories that came across my mental, man. Salute to the good man that's always jumping in the comments, sparking something in my memory. Like I said, this is my therapy, man. It's how I vent to y'all. So let's get it. I got a three-piece for y'all today. So number one is going to be, man, how petty and the simple things that people end up getting hit for when you're over that jail, right? So we had two dudes who, we was in a dorm. So they were sleeping in the right, they was sleeping in the bottom left of the dorm, you get what I'm saying? And the dudes down there, they had some weed, they had some drink, they had some strips. So these two other dudes that were sleeping on the top tier, they was trying to get down there so they can, you know what I mean, be around the action. Now, the two dudes that slept down there, they was just homeboys, cool friends. They only wanted to be right there because they was around each other. They had known each other from uptown on the streets. So they wasn't trying to move. So the dudes that was up top kept asking them, like, look, man, can we buy the, we try and buy the bump from y'all. You feel what I'm saying? We try and get down there so we can bust a move. They like, no, man, we really don't want to sell it. You know, we're cool. We're by each other. We just want to stay right here. We don't even want to go up there. It's rowdy at nighttime. So they really wasn't trying to move. So the dudes on the upstairs tier, they like, yo, come on, man. We trying to get down there with y'all on some, with y'all on some tight time. Y'all ain't trying to leave each other. We'll even sell y'all two bunks up here. We'll swap out for y'all. They like, no, man, we just don't want to be up there. It's always problems, commotions, this, that, and the third. So the dudes on the top tier, they so hungry and ill and they so chasing their habit. They like, look, man, if they ain't going to sell us the bunk tomorrow, we're going to go ask them one more time. If they say no, you already know what time it is. It's time to strap up. So right then and there, they already putting together the plan to go ahead and butch these dudes over two bunks. Just so they can be close to the action. Now, just picture this, right? Imagine they go down there. We're going to get back to that. So boom, right? It goes the next day, they go down there and holler at them for real. They say, man, what's up, man? We asking y'all one more time. We trying to buy the bunks. We're even up the price. They like, dude, we don't want to sell it, man. We just want to be down here. Can you please just leave us alone? So they like, all right, best say less. Boom, they goes upstairs because the dorm situated top tier, bottom tier for real. So boom, they go back up there where they at. They go suit up. Of course, y'all know the famous package. They throw that jacket on. They throw that scully on. They throw them gloves on, tie them boots tight. They head back down. Now, when they look over the tier, they see the two dudes is just laid back for real, chilling. One on the top bunk, one on the bottom bunk. So you usually just hang over the edge, talk to one another. So they moving like that. They walk down there. They come right there. Now, the dude's so green, they not even peeping at the dudes are tired and changed and they gang faces is on. So when they get right there, they still had the nerve to say, what's up? What's up, man? They up them joints. One dude, the way the bunks is set up is two bunks right here, a little row, two bunks, two bunks, two bunks. So one right here on this side of the bunk, the other one right here on this side of the bunk. They come right there. They say, man, pack it up. They're like, what? They say, man, pack it up. We're taking these bunks. So dudes like, man, what are you talking about, man? They up them joints. The dude on the left get to hit the dude on the top bunk. Dude on the right get to hit the dude on the bottom bunk. Now, y'all would think this would cause a commotion, but like I told y'all, we down in the jail, so this is the jungle right here, man. So when they hit the dudes for real, they jumping, screaming, trying to jump. This is how wild it is. The dude on the top bunk is trying to jump off the right side. The dude on the right hit him. So now he tried to jump over the left. Dude on the left hit him. The dude on the bottom trying to do the same. It's like they both just hitting one and one. I'm like, yo, we in the whole dorm just looking. These dudes are screaming, jumping. Finally, they jumps out the bunk for real. The dudes back up, tell them, man, pack it up now. They grabbing, they, I'm talking about dudes is literally leaking out, trying to grab a bunk, grab a mattresses and little sheets and stuff out the bunk. Boom, they grabs it, hurry up, run to the bubble, because the way the dorm is set up for real, the bubble right here, this is the open day room, bunks everywhere, steps lead to the top, bunks everywhere, same thing. So when they runs to the bubble, of course, the CEO's in there, boy, lollygagging, doing nothing, not paying attention. They get the banging on the bubble, help, help. They open the door, man, what's going on? Of course, he pops the cellie, pull the door. Two dudes fall, and of course, they already know, don't say nothing. They come and say, man, we can't live here. We was back there playing. We ain't, like I told y'all, we say some of the dumbest shit when it's time for us to say why we got stab wounds on it. We was back there playing, and we fell, and we just scratched ourselves, and they go to medical, and this, that, and the third, and they got rolled out the tears, sad to say, and them dudes moved down into them bunks because it was two open bunks. So the next two inmates that came in, the dudes upstairs, they had already moved down there, so they told them, nah, y'all up there up top. Crazy over a bunk, man. Over a bunk. Now, let's just say after they did that, they got right there, or they would have got knocked off. They never would have got the bunk in anyway. You get what I'm saying? Or they would have got down there, and the dudes that they was trying to get in contact with didn't even want to deal with them. They don't even want to hit them. They don't even want to serve them. all that would have been for nothing, man. But these is the tedious things that people end up getting hit for. Let's jump in the story too, man. We got revenge at his best. So we had an elder dude, right? I told you I'm a young man. So this man was probably in his late 38s, probably about 40, late 30s, early 40s, one of the two, you get what I'm saying? So he was a dope fiend addict, you get what I'm saying? He had a real, real bad heroin addict. He was always just, that was his thing, you know what I'm saying? So he was always in and out the system. So this time he gets locked up. He coming through, he going through his withdrawals, he ailing, he depressed, he not eating. So dudes is picking on him, you get what I'm saying? Dudes going in there. He had people that loved him, he really did. So he would get little packages here and there. Dudes is tricking him out the package. They selling him a dime bag for half his. They charging him something that costs $10. They charging him $40 because they know how bad he want this drug. You get what I'm saying? So they abusing him. They running down on him when they get bored. Dudes running in the cell, taking what they want from him. They smacking him around because they treating him like he a fiend. They treating him like he is less than a man. You get what I'm saying? So boom, here come where things get a little tricky at. One day we get a new intake come on the tier. Now when he comes on the tier, the dude that's going that got the habit, he know the dude, they know each other from uptown. So when he come in, the dude that's coming in as a new intake, he kind of respected for real, but he on man time. He cut up, he work out, he got himself together. He don't have a habit no more, but they used to get high uptown together. So when his friend Sam, he like, damn, Johnny, man, what's up? He like, man, what's up? You know, he looking bad for real. So he trying to keep his head down. He not really making eye contact. So his friend is seeing the way he being treated. He like, nah, Johnny, man, we ain't going for that. He a true friend. So the dude try to put him in detox. Now, detox is when you try to get somebody one off drugs. So every day he making sure he's staying close with him. He trying to slowly get his health back, get his food, because you don't have an appetite, nothing like that. So he's slowly getting them fruits up in him. He getting a little food in him. He's slowly starting to take him around the track. You would literally see these dudes. He trying to run around the track, but he ain't got enough energy. So they started off walking. Then they started off jogging. About 4 or 5 months later, you see him running around the track. I'm talking about, man, the dude probably came in. When I first met Johnny, he probably weighed 120 pounds. 6 months later, he was probably 230, all muscle. 230, all muscle, man. So one day, we on a tier in a group of dudes that was always used to pick on him back in the day. About 6 months ago, he see them dudes down there by the phone. So he coming down, he trying to make a call uptown to call his wife. He had got some news, something was going on real urgent with his wife. He wanted to call uptown, make sure everything was okay. So he go over there to say, man, listen, man, can I jump on the phone real quick, man? I got to call my wife. You know, if anybody in line, can I pay somebody to cut it? I'm just trying to make a phone call. So they going off, what, man, if you don't get your dope, man, what, get away from here. They going off just then the third. Man, he loses it. He grabs the phone, grab the dude. I'm talking about get the mash in his face with the phone. He takes it off the hook. You hear that, like, if y'all know the payphone got a little silver cord connected to it to the box. So when he hit him, the cord pop. Mop! I'm talking about drags him to the ground, beat that boy face with the phone. The phone is off the cord now. It's off the box. He beating his face with the actual phone. Mop, mop, mop. You just see blood spurting out. I'm talking about all his little homeboys that used to be beating on him, and they riding and they talking all this, man. They seen that first shot of blood squirt out that boy nose when that phone hit him and mixed with that fist. They get the, oh, I'm talking about, they literally get the taken off, bro. Taking off, left that boy. I'm talking about shorty punished him. Then boom, man, he get done. He tell him, man, listen, I ain't playing with y'all. I know what it was back in the day. This ain't that no more. I ain't going for nothing no more. Y'all lucky I don't really punish y'all in here, because he look at them as like, you know, they younger dudes for real, so they ain't know no better. He said, man, if y'all was old, I promise y'all I'd have made one of y'all jump off the top tier. And mind y'all, now at this point, he looking like a baby gorilla. You get what I'm saying? So needless to say, he never made that phone call to his wife because he broke the phone. But he could have, though, because we got three phones on the tier and dudes was looking at Joe like, whoa, he bugging. I don't even know who this guy is. But that's revenge, man. When he first came in and he had that habit, dudes was kicking him up his butt. 6 months later, thanks to his good friend, he got him shook back into that weight. And that's why I tell people, man, you never judge somebody because of their habit. You get what I'm saying? This just might be the time of their life that they're going through, because I've seen plenty of dudes come back there looking like 100 pounds, looking like a fish out of water. 9 months later, they walk around looking like King Kong, because that's their natural weight. They done cleaned up. They done got themselves back together. So, you know, that was always a lesson that I kept in my mind, man. So let's jump into story three. Another petty hit. This is one of the pettiest hits I ever seen, man. So boom, we had my man Lil Rock. Now Lil Rock, he on the tier for real. He come down, he try and get on the phone. So as I told y'all, it's always normally a long line on the phone, a short line, but it's always going to be a line. So he asked the dude, man, who next? He say, nobody, I got you. So he already clarified, all right, hold me down on the phone. He say, all right, that's a bet. Boom. 10, 15 minutes later, he come out. He see a whole nother dude on the phone. So he goes like, yo, what you doing on the phone? He say, what you mean, I'm next? Now at this point, it's probably about 5-6 people behind him at this point. So he go find a dude that he had asked to hold him down on the phone. You know, he looking for him. So he finds him in his cell with his homeboy for real. He coming there. He like, damn, no, I thought you were gonna hold me on the phone. He said, man, I had looked around. I ain't seen you. I ain't ready to hunt you down. He like, damn, that's how you feel. He said, man, get the fuck out of my face. I ain't your father, man. I looked. I ain't seen you right there. I think I called your name once. You ain't hear me. What you want me to do? Yo, I ain't your father. I ain't ready to hunt you down for you to use the phone. You know it's 15-minute clips. If you wanted the phone, you should have came back out there. Boom, I ain't got time. That go ahead. So yo, like, yo laughs it off. All right, that's a bet because the two dudes in there, him and his celly in there talking for real. And this was so crazy how ironic it was. It was commissary day. Like, we had just went to the store like an hour prior. You get what I'm saying? So boom, dude goes in his cell. He go in his cell, come back. Literally, we just see him standing in front of the cell. Man, he up. I'm talking about a bone crusher like this big piece of steel, something crazy. He must have cut that out the locker. He up that joint telling man, bag everything up. So they looking like, what? Bag it up. So boy, you just hear, all you hear is the totes coming up from up under the bunk. They throwing it in the laundry bag. He toss him another laundry bag. Now he tell his celly, man, you bag up too. So now the celly looking like, what the fuck? What I bag it up? You heard what I said? Sitting there with that big piece of steel right there. The celly do what he told to do. He start going in lockers up under the bunk. That was crazy, bro. But when they bag it up, put everything in the bag, he say, man, so he they throw the bag down like he ready to go get it. He say, man, toss it to me. Boom, he toss it to the dude, get it, roll out. Now, that right there already crazy. The phone call that cost you both your commissary bags. The celly stands up, crank Lil Rock. Ma! So now they in there, you got my bag too. So now they in there getting into a, they get into a, COs come on the tier. They go in there, mace them, lock them up. Now they done lost their bag, going to lock up, wasted money, got robbed, all over. You just not hold, keeping your word and holding that man down on the phone. And y'all might think it's crazy, all this transpired over somebody not holding them down on the phone. But I'm telling you, man, when you behind that wall, bro, it's the littlest thing that caused the biggest problems. And people always say, it ain't the dollar. It wasn't the 50 cent that he owed me. It was the principle. It was respect. That's AKA for pride. They pride won't let them just say, all right, man, you know, next time, bro, don't. All he could have said was, bro, next time, yo, don't forget me. You feel what I'm saying? Or the dude could have been like, my bad, bro. Whoever next on the phone, y'all throw a little rock or man. I was pulled. I messed up. You feel what I'm saying? It's on me because men on man time. You get what I'm saying? Salute, man. Thank y'all for riding with me. You already know where. You locked on Stories With Me, man. I'm appreciating the support. I'm loving the love. Make sure y'all keep like, share, comment, and smashing that subscribe button. And also shoot your boy your cash app, man. Let's go.